Okay, so let's try to update.
How can we do that?
Because now we have direct link from the laptop to the Mario All-in-One. We basically don't have internet in the Mario All-in-One. And that means we have to download the firmware to the laptop, unzip it, and then we go to setup and use the offline update. And if you hover, you can basically tells you the instructions, the button. So let's go ahead and do that. We go to GitHub, OpenIPC, repositories, and the builder should be, there it is, builder. And if you go to latest release, you will find all the firmwares in zip form. You need to find this one. That's the one that we want. So let's download it. Save. Okay, and here it is, down here. And if you right click, extract, and then inside this folder you'll find another tar file, zip file in tar form. And then again you unzip this, so you will have two files, this and this, two files you will need. And you need to move those two files in the same folder of the OpenIPC configurator. Okay, these are the two files now. And if you go here, you click first which firmware you want to install. So if you downloaded firmware for Ruby FPV, you would need to click Ruby and then offline update. But now we have downloaded the WFB-ng version of OpenIPC. Therefore, we click this button, enter, and now offline update. We are basically sending those two files to the camera. We click enter here, and then we start the update offline without needing any internet connection to the camera. While this is happening, you should not touch anything on the computer, because if you interrupt this whole process while it is happening, it might end up having corrupted the files in the camera, and that is quite tricky to fix it. You will need to go through the bootloader and flush everything manually. It's really complicated. It's for experts, basically. So just don't touch anything while this is happening, and you should be fine in a few seconds. Okay, so it's done now, and it has rebooted already, and you can see that the LED is working fine. That's a confirmation that everything on the camera is okay. And now that we finished the update, we need to send our custom key, the drone key that we previously created on our ground station. Like, for example, in my case, I used a Rapta 03W to generate the keys on the Radska, and then I transferred by clicking receive drone key from the Radska to the laptop. So I have it saved already here, and you can see it here. This is my private encrypted drone key. So now I can send it to the Mario camera by clicking send drone key. Again, just make sure that the IP is correct and it is selected the OpenIPC camera as an option here. And that's it. So now we need to reboot the camera by hitting the reboot button. And you should be able to have video now.